I'm Tracy Thomas, host of One for the Books, a literary live event series from LAist. Join me and authors Attica Law, Van Lathan Jr., and Jeff Yang for a night of book talk, games, and fun on September 14th at the Crawford. Tickets are available at laist.com/events.
LAist Studios.
Today on the LA Report. You're paying over $5 a gallon again for gasoline in Los Angeles County. A tent city for unhoused people coming soon gets a tepid early reaction.
Although it's really laudable that Culver City has done this to house 20 people, it's not going to address the magnitude of the problem that we're seeing.
And an August 1st deadline looms for many tenants to get right on unpaid rent. Good morning. It's Thursday, July 27th. I'm Suzanne Whatley, and you're listening to the LA Report from LAist 89.3. The average price of a gallon of regular gasoline in Los Angeles County is back up to $5 a gallon. Over that, in fact, the overnight increase of more than 2 cents brings it to nearly $5.03. That's the highest amount since the end of November. It's gone up 5 of the past 6 days, including about 2.5 cents day before yesterday. The Orange County average is approaching the $5 mark after a 2 cent overnight increase. It's now more than $4.95 a gallon. In Santa Monica, crews shaved off a section of the bluff overlooking Pacific Coast Highway, finishing the work ahead of schedule yesterday. The work to remove a cracked section of the cliffside required the closure of the westbound 10 at the end of the freeway and snarled traffic before it was reopened in the late morning. There was concern that the unstable portion of the bluff could collapse onto the highway below, which also had to be closed to accommodate the repairs. Culver City plans to open 20 tents for unhoused people in the city in the coming days. LAist senior reporter Nick Gerda says officials call the new shelter a safe sleep location.
Culver City is among many local cities struggling with homelessness. The latest estimate available shows over 300 people live without shelter. Each of the new tents sleeps one or two people, and on-site services include laundry, Wi-Fi, even yoga and meditation. Culver City Mayor Albert Vera told us the city is trying to speed up its efforts to address homelessness.
We were able to fast-track some of these projects.
Kathy Sweetser is a Culver City homeowner who represents unhoused people in civil rights cases. She says the tents are a step in the right direction, but don't go far enough.
So this site, although it's really laudable that Culver City has done this to house 20 people, it's not going to address the magnitude of the problem that we're seeing.
The need, she says, is much greater. For LAist 89.3, I'm Nick Gerda.
More than a quarter of a million Californians are still waiting on pandemic rental assistance for which they applied through the state. Ben Christopher with CalMatters reports, as they wait, eviction protections continue to expire.
So low-income renters who weren't able to pay their rent as a result of the pandemic were able to apply for this money to help offset all of that debt. The state says a big part of the bottleneck is that there are hundreds of thousands of Californians who still haven't technically completed their applications, but advocates say many renters who tried to complete this paperwork didn't have the language support they needed, or they got denied but weren't told what was missing from their applications. As a part of a legal settlement, the state has agreed to simplify the application process and to try to clear through the backlog by the end of this year, but that's going to be too late to help a lot of renters, many of whom are on the verge of eviction. The last of the state's eviction protections are winding down. Oakland's moratorium lifted last weekend, and one in Los Angeles comes to an end on August 1st.
For more on the Los Angeles deadline, here's David Wagner, who covers housing for LAist.
So far, city rules have protected tenants who couldn't pay rent early in the pandemic, but the rules are about to change again. If overdue rent from September 2021 and earlier isn't paid back by August 1st, renters could face eviction. Documentary camera operator Cesar Alvarez lost all his income early in the pandemic. He's now back to work and slowly making payments on roughly $18,000 worth of COVID rent debt, but Alvarez says he and other tenants in this situation cannot make the August 1st deadline.
The economic impacts definitely aren't over. We're still crawling out of holes. Trying to rebuild is not easy, for sure.
Landlord advocates told us that owners are not counting on recovering these debts, but they are planning to evict tenants who still owe money. For LAist 89.3, I'm David Wagner.
Coming up, what is it about living in Southern California that has the region high on the list of people with Alzheimer's?
Get ready for How to LA Summer of Discover.
Oh, what is this?
We're checking out all the things that make this city great. The nature, the neighborhoods, and of course,
the movable feast that is Cheap Fast Eats.
The food.
Every dish that we have here, we grew up eating, or my parents grew up eating.
Oh my God.
Catch new episodes of How to LA Tuesdays through Fridays, wherever you get your podcasts.
It's what the audience wants, what the audience needs.
Back now to the LA Report. The climate crisis is pushing the planet into a hotter normal, and all the pavement and buildings in our cities contribute to the heat island effect. But cool coatings placed on streets and roofs can cool surface temperatures by reflecting solar radiation rather than absorbing it. V. Kelly Turner is a UCLA heat researcher who studies cool pavement. Her research found that these coatings may cool surfaces dramatically, but they also increase the radiant heat right above that surface where people are.
Cool pavement is one tool, and we have other tools, and it's about who is using a place, for what purpose, what time of day.
She says these cool coatings may have broader benefits if used with other strategies such as shade. There are no silver bullets when it comes to adapting to climate change, but Turner says shade, both from trees and built structures, is the best way to overall cool communities. About 108,000 people living in Los Angeles County have Alzheimer's disease. That's one of the highest rates in the nation, according to the Alzheimer's Association. Neurologist Sarah Kremen at Cedars-Sinai Medical Center says age is not the only determining factor.
Whether you have high blood pressure, if you have diabetes, if you have mental health problems, inflammation and pollution, there's a lot of other things that we just don't know. It's very complicated who gets Alzheimer's.
The counties of Orange, San Diego, and San Bernardino also made the list of highest numbers of cases in the nation. Pete Davidson will resolve a reckless driving charge by entering a diversion program and performing 50 hours of community service. Authorities say Davidson crashed into a home in Beverly Hills back in March. Nobody was hurt, though. Los Angeles County prosecutors say the actor and comedian will likely do his service with the New York Fire Department, where his father worked until he died responding to the September 11th attacks. In the forecast, our nemesis high pressure will continue to keep temperatures above normal away from the coast into the first half of the weekend. Then it'll start to retreat Sunday. Today's temps are expected to top out 5 to 10 degrees above normal, with highs reaching the upper 70s to low 80s at the coast, the upper 80s to mid 90s in the valleys, upper 90s to mid 100s in the Inland Empire. In the mountains, mid 80s to mid 90s. High desert highs will be in the mid 100s and upper 110s in the low desert communities. And similar highs are expected for tomorrow and on Friday.
I'm Antonia Cerejido. LA Made from LAS Studios tells the story of bold local innovators. In the new season of LA Made, MG Lord and I tell you all about Barbie.
It's the true story of the making and marketing of the most famous doll in the world, told by the people who did it. We'll hear from Mattel co-founder Ruth Handler, who spent years trying to convince her own company to make a teenage fashion doll.
I think that the men were less daring than I was.
It was a different time. He's going to buy a doll with breasts.
You may think you know Barbie, but we promise lots of surprising and sometimes hilarious stories, like how Ken was created by men who didn't want him to be manly.
And here stood this doll that looked exactly like Barbie in the crack. And I was shocked. And I said, well, look at the way you built Barbie with those bosoms.
Subscribe to LA Made, the Barbie tapes, wherever you listen to great podcasts.